Hey everybody, this video is part of our free online course on how to become a construction cost estimator in 90 days. If you like the video, click the link in the description to get the full course for free. Let's start off by understanding what construction cost estimating is. By understanding what it is, it will be easier to move on to explaining what an estimator does and what type of people should become estimators. At its most basic, the goal of construction estimating is to work out how much it costs to transform a set of drawings, specifications, and requirements into a finished product. We want to calculate a dollar figure to turn a set of drawings into a reality. If we want to give a definition, the estimating process is the process of calculating and approximating the total expenses associated with a construction project. It involves systematically evaluating all the costs, including materials, labor, equipment, subcontractors, overheads, contingencies, and any other relevant expenses needed to complete the project successfully. Before we look too much at the specific sets in preparing an estimate, let's look at the components of a cost estimate. If we first understand these components of the estimate and how they fit together, the process will make more sense. First, we have direct costs. Direct costs are construction costs directly associated with completing portions of the project scope. So if we were building a bridge, these are the costs for building the foundations, standing the structural steel, and putting in the guardrail. Direct costs are always associated with on-site physical construction works that form part of the finished product. Direct costs are made up of four key components: labor, material, plant and equipment, and subcontract costs. Indirect costs are the opposite of direct costs. Indirect costs, also known as overhead or preliminary costs, are expenses incurred by a project that cannot be directly attributed to a specific activity. Unlike direct costs, which are directly associated with a particular activity, indirect costs are incurred to support the overall project and are shared across multiple activities. Examples of indirect costs include management staff salaries, temporary office hire, and security guards. Indirect costs can be largely grouped as either recurring, where they are incurred continually throughout the project lifecycle, and non-recurring, where they are one-off expenses. Our total project costs are a combination of our direct and indirect costs. To our total project costs, we need to factor in some contingency, referred to as our risk and opportunity, which accounts for any uncertainties in our pricing. And finally, we can then add our profit margin. Now we understand the components of a cost estimate, it will be easier to understand the steps we need to follow to produce an estimate. At a high level, to produce a cost estimate, we first need to understand the project scope. We need to look at the drawings and specifications to understand specifically what we are being asked to price. Next, we'll calculate our direct costs. These are the costs to complete the physical construction works. Most work in a cost estimate is in calculating the direct costs. Then we calculate our indirect costs. We always calculate our direct costs first because these will influence our indirect costs, and our direct costs will be impacted by our understanding of the project scope. Next, we work out our contingency and finally add on our profit margin. The process we follow to calculate direct costs is as follows. First, we need to prepare our work breakdown structure and bill of quantities. Next, for each activity in our WBS, we need to understand exactly how we are going to complete that construction activity and what resources are required. Then, based on productivity rates and the quantum of work from our bill of quantities, we can estimate the activity duration. And from our base resource costs, we can then calculate our resource rates. The first step is to prepare our work breakdown structure and bill of quantities. What we want to do is break the project scope down into component pieces. For example, if the scope we are pricing has several different concrete slabs, we could break the scope down into slab 1, 2, and 3. Next, we want to measure or estimate each of the key quantities for each activity. For example, for a concrete slab, we will want to know the cubic meters of concrete, the meters squared of formwork, the tons of steel reinforcement, and so on. We will either need to measure these quantities from the drawings or estimate the quantities using estimating rules. It is critical to get these quantities right because these quantities will ultimately be driving our cost. For each activity in our WBS, we then need to understand what resources we need. We need to understand the delivery methodology and exactly how we are going to do the work and what is required to do it. The resources needed for each activity will be a combination of labor, plant, materials, and subcontractors. For example, for slab 1, we would need concrete, a concrete pump, concreters, formworkers, and so on. Next, now we know what activities we need to complete and what resources we need to complete them, we need to estimate the duration we need these resources based on productivity rates. Our resource duration will then be the quantum of work from our bill of quantities divided by our productivity rate. For example, if we need to complete 100 meters squared of formwork at an average productivity rate of 1 meter hour per meter squared, then we need 100 meter hours for formwork. Then, once we've worked out our resource quantities, all we need to do is multiply these quantities by our resource rates. If we need 10 meters cubed of concrete, then we multiply this by our resource rate of $120 per meter cubed to get a total cost of $1,200 for concrete materials. If we need 100 man hours for formwork at $65 per man hour, then our cost is $6,500 for formwork labor. We can then simply sum all these together to get our total activity costs. The basic process of estimating is incredibly easy and intuitive. The hard part is coming up with accurate quantities and production rates. In summary, estimating is the process we follow to turn a set of drawings and specifications into a cost. This process is most used in the pre-construction phase when a contractor is tendering for work. This is when they are asked by a client to quote, to complete a project. They need to prepare an accurate estimate of the costs they expect to incur to complete the project. They then submit this dollar figure plus a profit margin to the client. If the client accepts their price, they will then sign a contract based on this. However, estimating does not just occur during the pre-construction phase. Estimating also happens during the feasibility stage, where the project owner or developer needs to understand costs to make important design decisions. Further, estimating is also used during the construction phase to price variations and changes to scope and to accurately forecast completion costs.